usually I have dinner here after end of day, or I just wanted to chill out because look at the water.
I arrived here in Shaka. Shaka is one of my favorite breakfast place. I said one of my favorite. And you see they even have a sweet note here. Kosh and watch out for falling coconut shell. Yeah, I am doing that like all my life because the place where I live, it has even more. Wow, this is a bit deserted. This is not the usual Shaka I know of. And you know, it's a weekend. Shaka, the healthy alternative, cloud nine Siargao. So we'll see here. Okay, at least there's a few people. We're heading towards the beach side. So most of the restaurants here are on the beach area. Oh my gosh, I miss Shaka. This is all their food. They serve the smoothie bowls. Oh, this is my favorite. In Bali, I eat this like a lot in Crete. Hello.
Hello,
morning. They still have that combo, no?
It's 350 now, ma.
What? 350 na karun? Okay, COVID prices, I would understand that. Kato mo na, pwede man cappuccino ang coffee ato, no?
Yeah.
Asa tong na yogurt na na kuan?
Super Bowl.
A Super Bowl to? Sige.
Okay lang, instead of kinawa mga more granola.
Yeah. So while waiting for my food, I just realized, oh my god, I have so much memories here in this beach and in this swing. There's a swing somewhere there. Yeah, that swing. I have so much memories here in Shaka. Been here with friends, with a, you know what I'm saying, with a somebody. And yeah. The waves are so nice today. I don't know why am I surfing like during cloudy day and during rainy day today, because this day is such a nice day. Maybe I go surfing tomorrow or later this afternoon, but I think it's heading low tide. I'll show you. So one of the best thing you can do here in Siargao is to try Shaka. Shaka is just here in Cloud 9. This is where the surfing spot is located. This is not so far. Actually, this is walking distance from Jacking Horse. So this combo is very good for your body. It has fruits, yogurt, and granola. So try it today.
So here we are on our lunch and Arnie prepared really yummy food and healthy food. I just came from biking, that's why I look really big mess. You cannot see my bike because the sun, my cam, the sun, everything else is just messed up. But Arnie's so beautiful and an amazing cook and an amazing person, and I just wanted to say hi to Jerry. If you're watching this, I hope we can all share what Arnie has prepared today. Let's see. Oh, pancit, buffalo wings, corn, kiwi. We are spoiled by Arnie. So, I will also include some of my dinner trips or some dinner experiences here in Siargao. And yeah, if you are new to my channel, my name is Lady E. And welcome to the island life.
So you guys are probably in my channel because of the blue ternate video that I uploaded about a year ago. This is blue ternate Euclitoria ternate, scientific name. This hangs in a wall next to the water. So it is quite a surprise that it tolerates the salt mist from the water, and it's really blooming so well. And you can even see pods here. You see, these are the seed pods. So not all the flowers turn into a seed. And this is blooming so much, and it creates a good ambiance towards this wooden wall with an uplight. So here there are many herbs. This is Vietnamese basil, I think, but it does not look so healthy anymore. But I'm pretty sure this is Vietnamese basil. Sometimes they do it this way if it's so much rain and after flowering. But when you pinch the seeds, these are the seeds, then it can be brought back to life with better soil. This is mint. I just bought like mint outside. It's just 100 peso, and you have like this bunch of mint for your drink. This looks like a dill, but this is not a dill. It's called dog fennel. So dog fennel are usually being labeled here as dill, but they are different with dill, and their leaves though are similar. This is a lemongrass. I also made a video about lemongrass. So lemongrass is present in almost in every Asian cuisine, and they are very hardy. Like, you see all the soil here is just like dirt from, I don't know, from outside. And here is a healthier version of thai basil. Let me just smell it. Yeah, confirm. Oh my god, I remember pho. You know, like this pho in Vietnam, it reminds me of that. And some new propagation of blue ternate. Wow, this is so amazing. I'm pretty much surprised. So thanks to my friend Robert, he introduced me to this place. And then we will check if ever they serve good food. So if you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, please subscribe. And I am currently here in Siargao. I'll be back in Cebu and probably be somewhere in the next couple of months. So now I'm so tanned. I'm here at the boulevard, and there is a gorgeous sunset right there. Usually I have dinner here after end of day, or I just wanted to chill out because look at the water. I mean, it's not as good as you can see because there are seaweeds, depends on which time of the day. But it's generally kind of a peaceful place, and it's a public place where you can just chill out. So you see there are families right there. This is where usually the boats are being docked most times, and you can have a drink or some refreshments right there at the back. There is a halo-halo and a burger station. If you are not familiar with Philippine dessert, halo-halo is our kind of dessert, which is, I would say, distinct here. So it means mix in English, but it is called halo-halo. So I will maybe put a picture here, and this is how my day goes. So hi to everybody who are really religiously watching this, like Mark, Troy, Jeff, Dave, and Jerry, and a lot of you. You guys know you are Dark Cider. I miss you. Don't run away from me. Don't run away from me, Dark Cider. So here and having a dinner, my food is just being grilled, and maybe I will share to you my food in the screen right now. So I hope you watch my channel. Thank you for those who subscribe, and I catch you guys next time. This is fish. We are having our dinner. We have a kind of sausage. This is for Arnie. Well, this is a good size. This is chorizo, vegetables, eggplant, and we've got some sauce, rice, and we're here at Mama's Grill, Siargao. This is my usual dinner here, just grilled stuff for a barbecue. For light breakfast or snack, it's cocoa bread. for a dollar here, about 50 peso, you can have this freshly cooked bread, and it's still super hot. So let's take of this a bite. Super yum, super hot. 50 peso for 10, it's like 5 peso each, so if you have nothing. And it is really a delicacy, quality bread. And look at this inside, it's the goodness of the coconut. So, island life. There's people working there in front, out of something, fixing a kind of bowl. And just the beach. Fresh cocoa bread. Arnie, I wish you were here. Having a breakfast here with Arnie, and this is their breakfast setting, kind of al fresco. This is the breakfast that we have. I've got eggs, bacon, fruits, coffee, and Arnie got some omelette set here. So not so busy today, and we've got a killer view here. It always amazes me every single time I am here in Siargao, like how little is this island, but there is a food or a place for everybody. If you're a solo traveler who likes a burrito, or you're with friends, but this is the ultimate island experience. Raw squid, raw sea grapes, and raw sea urchin. Have you tasted sea urchin?